be like that, just given that all the time that she's spent with the Spurs and in kind of the men's league, and just as familiar as she is with it now. But I don't, you know, it, for any team that is looking at trying to make a different hire and go a different route and try something new, I think Cheryl Reeve would absolutely be qualified and have the ability to make that transition. You know, she comes in and surrounds herself with a great staff that she trusts. I mean, she could absolutely be successful, even though she has not been on an NBA bench yet. We've seen it, you know, time and time again, how some, you know, college coaches get hired straight from college with very little or no NBA experience and things like that. So I don't think that I would use the fact that she has not been on a men's bench as an assistant as some sort of disqualifier for her, for sure.
Right. I think it would be fascinating. And I could see either of those working too. I think Ryan Saunders could calm things down and do a good job. I think Cheryl would be great. It would also be historic whether she won or not. It would be historic for her to do it. And it would be, you know, that'd be a cool thing for Glenn Taylor's legacy to be able to be the person who gave her that opportunity. And again, as you said, we're way out over our skis here. It's just pure speculation and guesswork, but it's interesting to say. Let's do one more Twitter question and a final thought from John. Again, thank you to TSR Injury Law, 612 TSR Time, sodastick.com. Go to their website to check out their new releases and follow them on Twitter for the new releases. John, give them the promo code again for your place.
Yeah, it's theathletic.com/JohnPod, JONPOD, all lowercase, for 40% off a year subscription, $2.99 a month.
And remember, Saturday and Sunday, we're running Vikings 2018 as the promo code. Vikings 2018, all one word. And that will get you $10 off your BiteSquad.com order. Go to BiteSquad.com, enter Vikings 2018. You'll get $10 off. That is on Saturday and on Sunday. And obviously, that's geared toward a weekend of sitting around watching football and eating great food, because Bite Squad does deliver all the best local restaurants. Final Twitter question from Jay. What's the ideal Andrew Wiggins breakout year look like?
Well, yeah, I think it looks like a more well-rounded player. Now, we've seen him score and score at a high level. And so it's not necessarily that he has to, you know, put up 26, 27 points a game. I think what you want in a breakout Andrew Wiggins season is, okay, he can stay around 20 to 22 points a game, hover right around there, but bring those rebounds up to 6 a game, you know, bring up the assists to a couple a game, show just a little bit more of that well-rounded type of approach from an offensive standpoint, because I do think, Jim, that he is coming up and starting to play better defense. Now, you can look at their defensive numbers as a whole and they're terrible, and that's true. But I think individually, he's starting to show a little bit more on that end of the court. And so what we want to see is just him become less one-dimensional as an offensive player, and then obviously just become a lot more consistent. I mean, he can't go, you know, 2 or 3 games. He really can't go 3 quarters in a game and just be a complete ghost out there. And we've seen that again early in this season. He's been, he's been really assertive and really good in San Antonio in the first half. Then he kind of goes away in the second half. And so what you want is that consistency of effort and production through quarter one, through quarter four. And then you can start to say, okay, he's starting to put things together a little bit.
Let's get a final thought from John. Once again, we also have a deal with Bite Squad, BiteSquad.com, or go to the Bite Squad app. Your first order, your first delivery is free if you use the promo code TALKNORTH, one word, TALKNORTH. So if you want your first delivery free, use TALKNORTH. If you want $10 off on Saturday or Sunday, just this Saturday and Sunday, use Vikings 2018, one word. Final thought, John.
Yeah, well, I think that, you know, as much as I said to kick off the podcast that, you know, things have settled into a new normal with the Timberwolves and Jimmy Butler, one thing still has to be noted here is that, okay, they're 1-2, and Jimmy Butler is largely responsible for 2 of these losses. And I'll tell you why, is because in San Antonio, he came in and played pretty well, but he missed about 3 or 4 bunnies right at the rim that he would not have missed had he been in training camp all preseason and played in some preseason games. And so so you look at that, and that's a you know, that's a problem, or that's something that's on Jimmy Butler. And then he doesn't play in Dallas and the second night of a back-to-back because he's not in good enough shape yet, because he has not been in training camp and in practice. And so, you know, they lose a close game to the Mavericks, and you have to think with Jimmy Butler there, they would have won that game. So they could have potentially been 3-0 had they not had all of this drama, all of this chaos going into the season. And now they're going into a rough, rough stretch of their schedule, and they're going to need a lot from Jimmy if he is, you know, the guy who he told us after the Cleveland game that he's here for his guys. He's all about winning. He's going to give it his all of that stuff, you know. So as Tom Thibodeau and Scott Layden try and downplay the impact of this whole Jimmy situation, he is costing them games right now. He already has, with the way that things unfolded during the regular season or during the preseason. And so we'll see how long it takes him to get up and get rolling, so he doesn't have to miss back-to-back, so he has enough conditioning and enough juice in his legs, so he's not missing those bunnies. But it has been a real reason, one of the reasons why they're 1-2. He's not totally to blame, but let's not forget that this is what's been happening so far.
That is right on, man. That is exactly right. He, for all his talk about hard work and being with his guys and all that, he has cost this team. He basically betrayed this team, and it is hurting them in the standings and might be hurting them in the trade market as well, although we don't know for sure. Thanks to TSR Injury Law, SodaStick.com, The Athletic for sponsoring the program, and Bite Squad, again, promo code Vikings2018 for $10 off this weekend. Talk North for your first delivery free. Appreciate all of our sponsors and all of our listeners. It's going to be a fascinating year. Thanks to Jon Krasinski and Brandon Morton. We'll talk to you next week.